Welcome to session 4 of the Don't Fear the Hypo series. This session is using the CIA to help us to manage our blood glucose levels during exercise. Don't forget to download the slides and the infographic that accompany this video. You can do that by clicking in the link below. Let's start with a summary of session 3, where we talked about the glucose credit card and repaying a glucose debt after exercise. In phase one of glucose debt repayment, we have to pay the debt back now. That's about taking some carbohydrate on board, typically within the first 30 to 60 minutes after exercise. Then phase two of the glucose debt repayment is 8 to 12 hours after exercise. In this period, we're talking about recovering glycogen back into the muscles and into the liver, and this lowers our blood glucose levels. In phase three, lasts in about 24 to 48 hours, we're talking about the presence of GLUT4 in our system, making us more sensitive to insulin. And phase four is all about celebrating by getting into more glucose debt so that we maintain high levels of consistent insulin sensitivity. So in this session, we're going to start by looking at, will starting exercise with a high blood glucose level protect me from having a hypo? Apart from making you feel unwell and reducing your performance, starting exercise with a high blood glucose level will increase your risk of going into diabetic ketoacidosis. If you have enough insulin in your system to deal with a high blood glucose level and to prevent DKA, then your blood glucose level is likely to crash quite quickly as you exercise. So let's introduce the CIA of diabetes and exercise. We can use the CIA to help us to manage our blood glucose levels around exercise. The CIA are not the diabetes police. We're talking about carbohydrates, insulin, and activity. So let's start with carbohydrates. We've briefly talked about this a little bit before, and we'll go into more detail later in the next video. But starting exercise with lots of carbohydrate on board typically means we're starting exercise with lots of insulin on board. It's not a great idea. That will tend to lead to hypo. There is some evidence to show that taking small amounts of carbohydrates regularly whilst we're exercising can really help to prevent hypoglycemia. The next step in our CIA model is insulin. Now, the only reason that people with diabetes go hypo is that they have too much active insulin available in their body at that time. And of course, we are much more likely to go hypo whilst we're exercising. And this is because we have an increase in our insulin sensitivity. So we can look at ways of reducing the amount of insulin that we have on board during the exercise window. And there are a number of strategies that we can use here. And again, we're going to go into this a little bit more in another video. The third element of the CIA is activity. We can use different types of activity to help us manage our blood glucose levels. This can work for us whilst we're exercising, but it can also work at other times. For example, going for a short walk for 10 or 20 minutes can really help us to reduce the post-meal glucose spike that many of us see. Some types of activity cause our blood glucose levels to fall, and other types of activity cause our blood glucose levels to rise. The good news is that we can mix and match different types of activity that we are doing, or simply change the order of our workout as part of our blood glucose management strategy. Aerobic activities or cardio activities like walking and jogging and cycling tend to make blood glucose levels fall. We also know activities that are anaerobic, that fast, explosive activities like sprinting or lifting heavy weights tend to make our blood glucose levels rise. Now, when most people go to the gym, they start off warm up on the rowing machine or the running machine or on the bike, and then they move on to doing weights. This typically causes blood glucose levels to fall, and at the midpoint of their workout, they're experiencing a hypo. And then at the end of their workout, they're doing weights and resistance work, and this causes their blood glucose level to rise. If we just simply switch the order of the workout so that we begin with a short warm-up, then we do the resistance work, causing our blood glucose levels to rise a little bit, and then we finish with the cardio, causing our blood glucose levels to fall, then we have a much better blood glucose profile. And it's just simple things like this that can really, really help. I'm going to go into this in much more detail in another video, and I've got some great diagrams that really help to explain the science of what's happening. In summary, Starting exercise with high blood glucose levels does not protect you from a hypo during exercise and is not recommended. The CIA of exercise and type 1 diabetes, we can adjust three things to help us to manage our blood glucose levels around exercise: carbohydrates, insulin, and activity types. Don't forget to download the slides and the infographic that accompany this video. You can do that by clicking in the link below.